Coherent Doppler LiDAR Theory. In coherent Doppler LiDAR, laser pulses are transmitted into the atmosphere and interact with aerosols within the atmosphere. As a result of this interaction, laser signals are backscattered towards the laser source, which can be detected and measured through an optical detector. According to the movement of the atmospheric aerosols with respect to the laser source, backscattered signals may suffer a frequency shift, Doppler shift, that is proportional to velocity of moving aerosols. The Doppler shift delta Pfaff laser signals with lambda wave length is given by where nu is the velocity of the aerosols, i.e. wind velocity. Heterodyne detection theory. In heterodyne optical detection, local oscillator and backscattered signals are optically mixed through an optical coupler. The resulting mixed signal is then incident upon a photodetector. Both local oscillator and backscattered fields can be represented as where omega 0 is the local oscillator frequency and omega s is the frequency shift that backscattered signals may suffer. The optical intensity as seen by the heterodyne detector is given by the terms 2 omega 0, 2 omega 0 plus omega s, and 2 omega 0 plus omega s, are at higher frequencies than detector's bandwidth and will not be seen by the detector. As a result, the generated photodiode electric current will equal to where, and eta are detector's surface area and photoresponsivity, respectively. It consists of a DC component equals eta plo plus eta psand and AC component equals 2 eta plo psgos omega SD. Since plo greater than ps, then signal power can be calculated as detector's responsivity is related to detector's quantum efficiency through the following relationship. Where, ice electron charge, eta keys the quantum efficiency of the detector, his Planck's constant, nu is laser's frequency. In this system, backscattered signals are sampled at 400 MHz using a 14-bit ADC equipped with an onboard FPGA. The laser pulse frequency rate, PFR, is 20 kHz, which limits the maximum measurement range to 7.5 km. To estimate wind velocity, the frequency shift of scattered signals, Doppler shift, has to be extracted. Backscattered signals are broken into time gates to represent desired range distances and a power spectrum of each range gate is calculated by fast Fourier transform, FFT. A gate length of 128 data samples is chosen, which corresponds to 48 meters range distance. Due to low pulse energy, 14J/pulse, power spectrum accumulation is needed to improve detection probability and velocity estimation accuracy. The wind velocity of each range gate is estimated from the calculated mean frequency of a post-processed power spectrum around the peak frequency.